as a Syrian kid needs to be picked up for questioning. Jake, you're on point.
I play Jake, who's a police officer, and I'm on the wrong side of the fence when the cordon goes down. And sort of, this guy is, I said he's introverted, he's a little hardened, he's kind of a guy who's dealt with a lot in his life, and so he's a little closed off emotionally. And when he gets stuck inside, his first impulse is to protect himself. And so he sort of shirks responsibility and tries to, you know, see how he can survive, how he can, you know, get out, if that's an option. And his story is going to be one, ultimately, is seeing if he can, you know, step up to the plate and become the hero that everyone sort of needs him to be.
Jake.
And what's interesting about this show, for my character, is I'm trapped inside facing a perpetual state of hypervigilance, and there almost is no rest. And so you see this character being put into action all day, every day, and fighting for his life and everyone around him, quite literally. To have an actual cordon, an area of the town that's locked down because the virus is that lethal, there's not really a checklist for officers inside, officers outside, and it leaves you sort of left to your own devices. And these guys are trained to make the right choice, but if there isn't sort of an example for what is right, what is wrong, you're left to just kind of figure it out.
I love you.
What are you coming down with something?
So I play a character called Lex Carnahan, who's a real interesting one, because he, the area that the virus kicks off in is the area that Lex is in charge of. He's a policeman. He's a major in the police force, so he's in charge of that area. And he's kind of selected by the government to be the face of the official voice and the official kind of rules and regulations. And so I think that his conscience is challenged, his instincts are challenged, his love is challenged.
No, get up!
And friendships are challenged as well. So it's you get to see all of these different things, these different emotions that he goes through. And it's fascinating to play him. It's almost like every episode I read, I'm not one for reading ahead, I just sort of try and read what I'm doing. I discover something else about him, and it's a joy to find that out. I don't know if you know, but it's based on another series, on a Belgian series. And I've chosen not to watch that because I'm just enjoying discovering who this guy is and what he means to me and what his choices mean to me.
Don't go back to your place to pick up your stuff. Go straight to mine. You'll be safe there.
Jana, my character, gets trapped inside of the cordon. Yes, last minute. Her boyfriend is Lex, played by David Jesse. And Jana's character, she has a bit of intimacy and commitment issues. So right at the last minute, she's supposed to move in with her boyfriend, Lex. She has cold feet and decides not to, goes to work, and then realizes that she just made a huge mistake, that she wants to spend, you know, she wants to live with him. And so she decides, okay, I'm coming, and then there's the quarantine, gets locked in place. So just as she leaves, it's too late.
Listen, they're officially putting the hospital on lockdown.
Well, they don't want anyone leaving for 48 hours.
The virus spreads, and it spreads quite rapidly. So you have these people on the inside, you know, they're fighting for their lives, but they're, you know, up against really horrific and extraordinary circumstances. So they're learning who they are and who they're not and who they thought they were, you know. And yes, it is. So as that's increasing, but there's it's such a love story and a human drama as well. So you have these characters, you know, just trying to fight not just for their survival, but fight to hold on to their family and to their friends. So we get to see that unfold.
Cute kids. I'm supposed to meet Dr. Sanders. She was going to take them for a tour.
I play Katie Frank. She's an elementary school teacher and a single mom. She has a class of 14 11th graders, one of them being her son. And yeah, you know, it's a handful. And she brings her students to the hospital to perform some music for the patients the day that the virus becomes, you know, full-fledged. And so they get put under a lockdown in the hospital.
Is it bad? I've got 14 kids here. I should know if it's bad.
She's got a history. She's got a lot going on in her life. She's, you know, currently in a custody battle with the father's parents. So she's got the mother-in-law, Grace, constantly checking in on her. She has every parent worried. She's trying to keep the cool of the kids and just keep the, you know, because to have panic is not going to help anyone in this kind of situation. So keeping her cool while dealing with her own internal conflict is where she's at this point. So it's a lot. There's definitely the potential for Katie to develop relationships inside the court. And, you know, you have Jake, who's this man. They kind of butt heads a little bit. He's a cop inside the hospital, and there seems to be kind of an interesting spark there. So there's definitely the potential for something to develop there. Who knows what it might be? It might be foes, or they may find a romance. Who knows? And there's Kannert's in the hospital, who's a doctor, who hopefully, you know, he can inform Katie and give her a little peace of mind. So there's definitely the chance for some sort of relationship to develop in this weird, kind of different situation.
I don't understand what's going on.
Xander.
I'm coming to get you.
I'm Hannah Mangan Lawrence, and I play Teresa Keaton on the show Containment. And my character fits into the show. Well, we meet her, and she's trying to run away with her boyfriend because she's 9 months pregnant. But then the containment happens, and they section off the part of the city which she happens to be in, but her boyfriend's not. So there's the drama. I think it's just exciting, like, kind of being pregnant. Like, I've never played someone who's pregnant before, so that's kind of a whole new thing in itself.
You were supposed to get out. Why didn't you get out?
Don't. They said avoid contact.
I think it's definitely heightened. I think, I mean, I was already, before, like, kind of the sectioning off of the city happened, I was so, like, obviously I'm like a 17, 16-year-old girl who's scared about to be giving birth. I'm 9 months pregnant. So I think add that to, like, what's about to happen is just, I mean, I can't even imagine how I would be. I wouldn't get out of bed. I'd just be like a nervous wreck. But I think she's, like, you know, I think she's coping. I think she's trying to, like, think practically. There are moments where she, like, kind of deviates from that practical, like, thinking thought, like, thoughts. But yeah, I think she's doing well. The disease is like life and death, and so you're always thinking about it. It's always on your mind. But then I have, like, other things that then you've got everyday things to think about as well.
You understand the precautions we need to take, Dr. Sanders?
Yeah, I got it.
Tell me one more time.
Well, I play Dr. Kannert, who is stuck inside the quarantine area. He's basically the most qualified person to deal with this virus, this outbreak that's happening. And so he's got all this pressure. He's super stressed out, but he's like a duck on the water, basically. He's all smooth at the top, and underneath his legs are frantically, you know, underneath, crazy. So he's just in charge of everything in the hospital, basically, trying to find out what's going on.
I'm afraid I must declare the virus highly contagious and fatal.
There's all these precautions you have to take to not get infected, staying 4 to 6 feet. You learn a lot in this show, basically, because it's a very real thing, this virus. You learn a lot how to keep yourself safe. But my character is always getting involved, you know, with patient zero, with people who are infected, so I have to stay very safe. I'm conveying what's happening with this virus, and with that comes a lot of medical terminology, and it was a new language, basically. I'm learning Latin all over again. So it was was very difficult. But what's great about this show is we have advisors from the CDC. We're filming in Atlanta, so we have the CDC right here. We have medical advisors who's helping me with a lot of stuff. Even just how to put the gloves on properly, how to put the equipment on properly, you think it's a no-brainer, but no, there's very careful ways not to get contaminated. It's going to make a hypochondriac out of all of us.
It's not currently presenting as anything we can identify.
Well, kind of a reporter, kind of a blogger, kind of a hybrid of the two. I've been disgraced in the world, in the blogosphere, in the world of journalism, from some fact checking that gone awry, and that's where we find me, and trying to work myself back up into the world, and I kind of stumble upon what might be a conspiracy within the cordon. About what's actually happening. I'm outside, but I find some things out that are going on inside the cordon that could have some big consequences.
Girl is in there. So is mine.
You know, there's the debate about whether what I'm doing is really moral or not. You know, Lex, the main character, and I have these debates about, you know, whether I should be doing what I'm doing. Is it safe to let these people know about the truth, and is it going to put them in danger? And so we have these philosophical and emotional arguments sometimes about, you know, whether I should post things. Is it going to make it worse or better?